Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Mega Man X2 playthrough. In our last episode, we took out Crystal Snail, the final Maverick of the game, which means all 8 Mavericks have been defeated, but we are far from done with this game, because now it is time to take on the X-Hunters with the X-Hunter stages. And for this episode, we are going after X-Hunter Stage 1. So let's go ahead and get started. So the X-Hunter stages basically serve the same purpose as the Sigma stages from Mega Man X1. In fact, you could really say that the X-Hunter stages are just Sigma stages under a different name. They serve the exact same purpose. Basically, they're an extra set of levels that you have to beat in order to beat the game after you've defeated the 8 Mavericks. Now, for this first section, you're going to want to carefully make your way down the left side of the room. Don't try to immediately drop down, because if you do, you'll probably land in that spike pit and die immediately. So the X-Hunter Stage 1 isn't that bad. I mean, there are a couple sections that could give you trouble, but for the most part, X-Hunter Stage 1 is actually quite easy. Now, when you get to this part, you're going to want to use the Silk Shot in order to take out that Mook, because what that Mook is going to do is he will force the walls to close in, and if the walls close in and you're caught between them, boom, you're dead. It's a crushing death. And I highly doubt we want to get crushed. I certainly don't want to get crushed. I can't say anything about everybody else, but me? No, I don't want to die. Another little comment I want to make about X-Hunter Stage 1 is that I absolutely love the music track. This is probably my favorite piece of music in the entire game. Like I've said before, I don't like X2's soundtrack as much as X1, but X2 does have some pretty nice tunes. So, you know, it's still a pretty nice soundtrack, and this music track is among the best in the entire game. Now, right here, we have a branching path, and I'm actually going to show off both pathways for the sake of being thorough. Drop down the hole, and you will come across these pig robots from Overdrive Ostrich's stage. And if you go all the way to the end, you'll actually come across a health pickup and an extra life. So we have that to help us out. And if you go up this way, you'll come across a vertical shaft where you're going to have to get on these missiles and basically wall jump onto them in order to make any progress by going up. Now, ultimately, both pathways you can take at this point will take you to the exact same area, but I might as well show them off for the sake of being thorough. Now let's go back through the other pathway. I almost always take the upper path. Basically, going from here, I always take the upper path, but I thought I would show off the lower path for those who might be curious, because you never know. Someone might want to know what's on the lower path, and they'll be like, hey man, show the lower path. Okay then, there you go. Because I'm a nice guy. I'll show you all the ways to get through the stage. Now, this is the last... Oh, I couldn't quite get him. Yeah, this last Mook that likes to close the walls in can be a little irritating to kill, especially if you're not good at positioning yourself. But there we go. I really don't want to deal with the walls closing in. Seriously, if you can take those guys out with the Silk Shot, do it. It will make life so much easier, and it will take so much pressure off of going up the shaft. Believe me. And there's the boss door, ladies and gentlemen. It's now time for our first X-Hunter boss, and it's a very familiar foe. You'll want to equip the Bubble Splash for this, because our boss for X-Hunter Stage 1 is Violin. We last fought this guy back in Wheel Gator stage, and really, Violin's strategy is very similar to last time. He's still got the bloody spiked ball, but this time the room that he's in will have these blocks that will come out of the background, and these blocks can either help you or hinder you. If you're very lucky, what will happen is the spiked ball will rebound off the blocks away from you, and you'll never get touched. But if you have bad luck, you might end up trapped, and the block and the spiked ball will utterly annihilate you. Now, right here, he's got me in a bad spot because he was actually on top of the block, which made him a little harder to hit. But really, other than the blocks, Violin isn't any different from the first encounter. And if you play this game without going after the X-Hunters first, this is the only time you're going to face him. But it's the second time we're facing him because we've already fought the X-Hunters in the Maverick stages. And Violin, that spiked ball is still a pain in the butt to deal with. So, yeah, other than the arena, Violin still hits as hard as he did before. So be ready for a fight when dealing with this guy. Take that. Right up the butt.
What? How could he have overloaded my circuits?
But unlike the first encounter where Violin simply retreated, now he's gone for good. So that's one X-Hunter down, two more to go. X-Hunter Stage 1 is done. There's our password, and we are ready to move on. But ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a relatively short episode because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Mega Man X2 playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw here, be sure to like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Life Form RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.